As head of the Spanish Inquisition, Tomás de Torquemada presided over one of the cruelest, most tortuous events in human history. Thousands of innocent Spaniards died at his hand, giving rise to the moniker Black Legend and inspiring fear at the very mention of his name. Tomás de Torquemada was born on October the 14th, 1420, in Valladolid, central Spain. His family were among those known as conversos, having converted from Judaism to Catholicism a few generations prior to Thomas's birth. While still in his teens, he entered the San Pablo Dominican Monastery. This order was particularly known for its piety, austerity, and devotion to the church. Thomas soon established himself as more devoted and more pious than most. As a result, he was quickly elected to the position of prior at the monastery of Santa Cruz in Segovia. 15th century Spain was a conglomeration of kingdoms, each having its own rulers. The first half of the century was marked by civil war. An uneasy peace was established in the 1470s with the marriage of Isabella of Castile to Ferdinand of Aragon. At that time, there were three key religions in Spain: Catholicism, Islam, and Judaism. Ferdinand and Isabella were determined to unite the country under the Catholic banner. Torquemada had met the young Princess Isabella while she was in her early teens, becoming her confessor and personal advisor. As a result, his influence over Isabella, who became Queen of Spain in 1474, was huge. The priest and the queen shared an obsession with ensuring Catholic unity while eliminating all forms of religious heresy. Torquemada saw the real heretics as not being the Jews or the Muslims, but the conversos, those who had converted to Catholicism. Despite his own converso origins, he suspected all conversos to be false Christians who would contaminate the faith. As a result, conversos were treated as heretics, just as were Jews and Muslims. A common charge against conversos was that they considered Jews to be more their neighbors than Christians. By 1478, through Torquemada's influence, Isabella had convinced the king that the heresies occurring within the Spanish Catholic Church was the most pressing issue that the nation faced. She convinced him to press Pope Sixtus IV to appoint Torquemada as Spain's Inquisitor General. The Pope gave his assent, and Torquemada was handed free license to hunt down the conversos. He began by creating a list of heresies, along with a handbook that gave his enforcers guidance on how to identify the heretics. These included getting food and other supplies from Jewish rather than Christian merchants, and hanging out bedsheets on a Friday in order to observe the Sabbath. Then the conversos were rounded and cross-examined so that their heretical crimes could be identified. A climate of terror was quickly established throughout Spain. In every town and village, neighbors denounced one another. In the first couple of months of the Inquisition, thousands of conversos were imprisoned, with many of them starving to death. Torture was a well-established means of extracting confessions from conversos. Torture chambers included such implements of pain as the Judas cradle, a device that was composed of a tall, thin stall with a triangular-shaped seat, on which the victims were slowly impaled by being dropped onto it to create varying degrees of agony, and the pear of anguish, which was inserted into a chosen bodily orifice and then spread apart inside the victim, stretching and splitting the flesh as it did so. Torquemada's favorite torture device was a stretching rack called the potro. The victim was tied to a wooden frame and their body stretched as the bars moved in opposite directions, dislocating joints and causing extreme agony. The inquisitors who carried out this deadly work under Torquemada's direction struck first in Seville, with the first public execution taking place on February the 6th, 1481. The widespread panic that resulted saw 4,000 conversos fleeing from the city. Many of these were hunted down and thrown in prison. The Inquisition spread steadily through Spain, with tribunals set up in Cordoba, Jaén, and Toledo. Quickly, a pattern emerged. First, the people of a town would be prepared as the fear of God was preached to them from the pulpit. Then the inquisitors would arrive, and the Edict of Grace would be publicly read. The townspeople would then be given a period within which to come forward and confess their guilt. Those who did so had hope of redemption, or at least to have their lives spared. Those who did not could expect the full wrath of the church to come upon them. Once taken into custody, the single-minded goal was to extract a confession. Those who refused to offer it were tortured until they did, or died. Punishment ranged from acquittal, which was very rare, to imprisonment, flogging, or serving on a galley boat. The fuel that energized the Inquisition was anonymous accusations. Then, those who had confessed, either freely or through torture, were required to name other heretics. Failure to do so could lead to execution. In 1492, Torquemada convinced Ferdinand to issue a decree expelling all Jews from Spain. However, a delegation of wealthy Jews offered the king 30,000 ducats to rescind the decree. When he heard the offer, Torquemada appeared in front of Ferdinand with a large crucifix in his hands and declared, "Judas Iscariot sold Christ for 30 pieces of silver. Your Highness is about to sell him for 30,000 ducats. Here he is. Take him and sell him." This was enough to shame the king, and he proceeded to issue the decree which expelled 80,000 Jews from Spain. The severity of the punishments meted out under Torquemada's control eventually gained the attention of the Pope. Three times he summoned Torquemada to Rome to inquire of his practices, but each time the power that the Grand Inquisitor held over Ferdinand and Isabella protected him. Finally, in June of 1494, the Pope appointed four assistant inquisitors. This was done as a result of Torquemada's failing health, coupled with growing complaints at the viciousness of the Inquisition. Torquemada remained as Inquisitor General until his death on September 16, 1498. During his 15-year reign as Spain's executioner-in-chief, he was responsible for between 3,000 and 8,000 deaths. The Inquisition, however, did not die with him. It continued in various forms for another 300 years, finally coming to a thankful end in 1820. If you enjoyed this video, hit the like button and subscribe. If you have any other suggestions for future topics you'd like us to cover, please leave a comment below. And we'll see you next time on History Junkie.